Today we are going to do experiment 1, Pascal's law for robo 122 pneumatic systems. This experiment basically has two parts. The first part is to balance the load by extension. The second part is about balancing the load by retraction. We have included the third part, which is repeating parts 1 and 2 for 3 more workstations. So initially we will do balancing the load by extension on one workstation. On the same workstation, we would do balancing the load by retraction, and we switch to 3 other stations and perform the same. I shall show you the apparatus, and I shall show you how to set the apparatus with the head end of the cylinder upward. I shall show you how to mount the weight, unknown weight, and I shall show you how to set the air pressure, and we can balance the load. This is air supply main to the workstation. The technician or instructor would switch on. Now the air supply is ready for all the air supply units. The air is available here. Now this is the air supply unit for the workstation. For different workstations we can connect from different outlets. Now I am going to connect the input. I connected the main line here, and when I turn it on, it is going to be ready at these points. I have to turn on by taking it up. Now I am going to use this outlet for today's experiment. I have connected a 5x32 tubing here. This would go into the device. This is the apparatus for today for verifying Pascal's law. I am using station number 3. I shall show you station number 3, where you have the bore diameter marked. This is a 1/2 inch bore diameter station. This is air regulator unit. You see the dial. You have the markings for the air pressure. These tubes all would be connected. You don't have to bother about them. Your connection is from the air supply unit to the regulator inlet here. From this outlet, I am connecting to the regulator here. Just a press. If I have to take it out, I just press here to take it out. This is the apparatus. Here is your cylinder. This is your unknown weight. Now, the weight is suspended down. I am going to, this is the head end of the cylinder, okay? So what I am going to do, I am going to invert it so that the cylinder goes down and the weight is going to go up on top, and I can balance the load by extension. Now I am going to take out from here, invert the apparatus. Now the unknown weight is up. I am going to open the valve so that air is available to the regulator. Now it is at 20. The weight is not extended yet. I am going to adjust it, and I can go through this control and extend it. Do it slowly. You can use both of these, and you have to find the pressure required for extension, and you have to balance the load so that it doesn't fall like this and go like this. In between the two, I have to find a point where it balances the load in the middle of the extension. See? It's balanced. Now I am going to note the pressure at which this balancing has happened from the regulator. I have noted my findings here. 1/2 inch bore diameter station 3. for balancing the load by extension 16 PSIG. Now I'm going to shut off the power here and I'm going to invert the cylinder so that the weight is going to be suspended. I balanced it at this point. This is again by adjusting the control on the regulator slowly. It's going up and down here. See, you have to adjust it so that it balances. See, when you move this control, it goes up and down, and you have to slowly bring it to a point that it balances. See, it balances here. Now I'm going to note the pressure on the gauge. It's 18 PSIG. I've shown the readings for station 3. The calculations are to be done. We have given in the lab instruction all the formula required for calculation. Show your detailed work in space provided. This is station number 2 apparatus. Again, the bore dia is shown here. It is reading 1/2 inch. But the weight here is different. The unknown weight is different. So I am going to show you what would be the pressure for extension and pressure for retraction in this workstation. Station 2, bore dia 1/2 inch, I have noted. I am going to show the connections again. I am connecting the 5x32 tubing into the inlet of the regulator. The weight is mounted on the head end. I am turning on the air supply. I am going to adjust the regulator controls, this and this, and I am going to balance the weight up by extension. See, now I can say it's balanced, because when I go beyond this point and below this point, it's going up and completely down. So I'm adjusting it. Here. Now I'm going to note the air pressure from the regulator. It's showing 14 psi. I have noted the pressure for extension as 14 PSIG. Now I am going to invert the apparatus, and the head end is going to be holding the weight again, and it is going to be suspended. Air supply should be turned off before inverting the apparatus. Now the apparatus is inverted, the weight is suspended. Turn on the air. Adjust the air pressure. You need more pressure for this. So I'm just increasing air pressure and I'm going to adjust through this control. I have balanced at this point. I'm going to note the air pressure from the regulator. It is showing 16 PSIG. I have noted it here. Again, the calculations using formula should be shown. You should do the same thing for 2 more stations. Theory behind experiment 1, Pascal's law, is here. I have shown all on the board. Pascal's law states that force is pressure times area, right? Force is measured in pounds, and F is P times A, P is F over A, it's in pounds per square inch, PSI it is shown. When you measure with the gauge, it is PSIG, okay? A is F over P in square inches, it's marked as inch squared. Part 1 of the experiment is to balance the load by extension. I have shown the diagram
the unknown weight is mounted up and it is going to be lifted up. Maybe to balance it, you need to lift up and down a bit and know the correct spot where it is balanced. During extension, note something, the bore area is more. And so the pressure required to balance the load is less. The reason is pressure and area are inversely proportional. So I have shown PE is F over AE. AE is more and therefore PE is less. Part 2 of the experiment is balancing the load by retraction. I have shown here where the head end is and the cap end is. Again, the load is mounted on the head end and it is suspended because we reverse the apparatus. The bore area is going to get less because the rod is going to take up some portion of the area, right? So therefore, the bore area is less. Now, pressure required for balancing the load would be more. Again, the relationship between the area and pressure are inversely proportional. PR is F over AR. And with experiment number 1, Pascal's law.